old lakes. So in the U.S., most of the reservoirs, big and small, the heyday of reservoir building was in the 40s, 50s, 60s, a little bit into the 70s. So most of the reservoirs that we have on the landscape are 30 to 50, 60 years old. So one of the common things we're seeing now in the fisheries management world is we're starting to deal with geriatric lakes, aging reservoirs. And as lakes start to age, they go through a series of predictable changes in the symptoms we see kind of all over the place. So what do I mean by an aging lake? A farm pond, a reservoir, something that's been around for quite a while, and you start to see maybe on the upper end of the lake where the inlet comes in, the water's getting shallower, maybe there's more weeds up there because the water's shallower, there's more nutrients, so lakes start to fill up through time. Other things we see is we lose most of the habitat. When the reservoirs were built, and if they left the trees and shrubs and brush in there, usually after 20, 30 years, most of that stuff is long since decomposed. So a really common thing we see is we get into these old lakes, we'll have big shallow flats in the upper part of the lake, and we'll have the rest of the lake kind of a habitat desert. There's no, or very few small sticks, trees, things like that. You might have a couple old tree trunks, but that's about it. So what do we do about it? Very common thing. Some of the management practice, we immediately start an aeration program on those lakes. So we want to get oxygen down to the bottom, help process nutrients and organic matter, and slow down the sedimentation part as much as we can. The other thing we do is we fix habitat. We go back in and we find out where we're standing, and we try to bring up 20% of the lake to high quality habitat. Those are a couple simple things to do. There's some cases we've gotten into lakes and they're so old, they're so far gone, that the best thing to do is either drain them and dredge them out and re-sculpt the basin with some of the sediment, or if you're lucky enough and you got the room for it, you can simply add on 2 or 3 more feet to your dam if properly designed and reclaim some of that lake. You do something to get some of the lake volume back. Anyhow, this is one of the, we consider this one of the grand challenges in fisheries management, is what to do and how to tackle these aging reservoirs, because the older they get, the more they degrade, the harder it is to support and sustain high quality fisheries and good water quality. Okay, so how shallow is too shallow? When should I throw the towel in? Is it worth trying to fix some of these old lakes? And the answer, unfortunately, is it kind of depends. There's a latitudinal component to it. If you're up north and if you're much shallower than 7-8 feet, your risk of winter kill is so high that it's going to be hard to sustain a fishery. You get down south, Oklahoma, Texas area, we have plenty of lakes with 5-6 foot of water that do just fine. So it's not necessarily a depth thing. It's what are the risks to shallow water in my part of the world. Now, the good thing is it takes quite a bit for me to throw in the towel, because we have so many tools at our disposal. Aeration, both north and south, is probably your number one tool to not only slow down the aging process, but also to gain back some of that habitat that you would lose through stratification in the summertime. So it's just going to vary. It would take quite a bit. There's some lakes I've been in that are 18, 20 acres, and the viable deeper water in the lake might be confined to 5 or 6 acres. We still utilize those shallow areas. They just get taken over with vegetation, and we focus some of our management in those deeper areas without spending a lot of money doing dredging, things like that. So as long as there is some deep raw refuge and you have some of the tools available to you, you can let the lakes go quite a ways and still sustain fisheries in them. Okay, so another symptom of aging reservoir is degradation of habitat. We lose all the woody structure, the shrubs, the brush piles, even most lakes are just left with a few old tree trunks. So we want to bring it back to 20%. How do you do that? So the simple way to do it, and nowadays you can simply do it on your phone, several apps, Onyx, Google Earth, you can simply take your phone, walk the perimeter of your lake, and figure out the distance of your shoreline in feet, yards, whatever it might be. And once you have that total distance, for example, if you have 1,000 feet of shoreline, mentally you got to say, I need to impact positively 20% of that. So 200 feet of shoreline spread around my lake is where I'm going to focus habitat work. So I might do a 50 foot of shoreline here, and I'll stack up brush piles, artificial. I love cedar trees. Can't think enough good things about cedar trees. It's kind of a happy accident. A lot of wildlife properties, we want to get them off. We love them in ponds. So So I might do a 50-foot stretch, and in that 50-foot, I might put out 20 to 30 cedar trees, depending on how big they are, and just create a big habitat complex from shallow water, say 1 to 2 feet, all the way out to 10, 12, 13, 14 feet if you got it. You want to have one big band, all kinds of trees in there, touching, intermixed, and a big complex. And I might repeat that 4 or 5 times around the lake until I bring my coverage up to 20%. So that's a strategic breakdown, simple method. You can do it with your cell phone on how to do a habitat improvement in your lake.